गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वील डिस्कस अबाउट टाइप्स ऑफ प्लांट्स। सो सी, देर आर टू टाइप्स ऑफ प्लान, सिंगल यूज प्लांट्स एंड सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ प्लान इज स्टैंडिंग यूज प्लांट्स। सो फर्स्टली आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट सिंगल यूज प्लांट्स। सिंगल यूज प्लांट्स आर सच प्लांट्स विच आर डेवलप्ड फॉर सच इवेंट्स एंड प्रोजेक्ट्स विच occur only for once. So these are the plants which are prepared for the utilization for only one time. Again we want to use single use plant, again we have to frame them. They can utilize only for once. So under single use plant we can have two plants, that is program, another one is budget. Now move to the second type of plant, that is standing use plants. These are the plants which are developed for such activities which occurs regularly. So these are the plants which are prepared and can be utilized again and again. So standing use plants are including four type of plants. First is policy, second procedure, third method, fourth is rule. Now class, there are two more plans, that is objective and strategy. These are the two plans which are neither the part of standing nor the part of single use plans. So these two plans are not coming in any of the category. Clear? Now class, we will discuss all these plans one by one. So firstly I will discuss about objective. What are objective? Objectives are the end points for the attainment of which all activities are performed. So objectives are the end points for attaining them, means for achieving them all business activities are performed. For example, objective of a business organization can be to increase the profit by 25% or increase the sales by 10%. So anything can be set as the objective. Then all activities will be performed to achieve this objective. Now move to the second plan, that is strategy. Strategies are the comprehensive plan which are prepared to meet the challenges posed by the activities of competitors and other environmental forces. So basically the strategies are prepared to meet the challenges of the competitors. Strategies have three dimensions. First dimension is they are prepared for long-term objectives. Determining long-term objectives. Strategies are prepared to meet the long-term objectives. Second dimension is adopting a particular course of action. Under strategy, particular course of activities are involved. And third dimension is allocating resources to achieve objectives. Under strategies, resources are allocated in the form of money to achieve the objectives. So these three are the dimensions of strategy. Take an example of strategy. For example, Coca-Cola and Pepsi, these are two competitive company in the market dealing in soft drink. Suppose Coca-Cola has reduced the price of its soft drink to capture more share of the market. It means reducing price is the strategy of Coca-Cola. And to meet this challenge of Coca-Cola, Pepsi has also to do some of the activity. The activity which will be performed by Pepsi to maintain its market share will be considered as the strategy of Pepsi. So here I think that strategy is clear to all of you. Now class, we will move to the standing use plans. Under standing use plans, there are four plans. So firstly, we will discuss about policy. What is policy? Policy is the general statement which guide the managers while taking decisions. or you can say policies are the own way of manager to handle the situations. For example, this can be the policy of a business organization that credit sales are not allowed, or the firm deals with the wholesalers only. If a firm is having a policy of dealing with wholesalers only, it means this firm sells goods only to the wholesaler. This firm is not having contact with the retailer or any consumer. So this is the meaning of policy. Policies are the general statement that guide the managers while taking decision. Now, second standing use plan is procedure. Procedure are the sequential steps which are prepared under the framework of policy to achieve the objectives. It means procedure are the step-by-step process, and these procedures are prepared within the policy framework. And why they are prepared? To meet the objectives. These are the exact manner of doing the work. For example, now I will discuss with you procedure of recovering money from the debtor. Like, if a firm has to recover money from the debtor, their first step can be to send letters to the debtors that return money of the company. After receiving letter, if debtors are not returning the money, then that company can do a phone call to such debtors. Even after attending the phone call, they are not returning the money, then that firm can send someone to such debtors to receive money. Even then, if debtors are not returning the money, then that firm is taking a legal action against such debtors. So this can be the step-by-step process of a company to recover money from the debtors. So this will be the example of procedure. Now move to the third type of standing plan, that is method. Methods are the standardized way to perform a task, or methods are very detailed. They are more detailed than procedure. Or you can say methods are the standardized way that how every step of procedure will be performed. That's why methods are more detailed than procedure. For example, there can be different methods of giving training to the employees. But for the top level management, company is utilizing orientation and seminar method to give training to the top level management. And for the lower level management, company is using apprenticeship method and induction method. So these will be the example of method plan. Now, fourth type of standing plan is rule. Rule are the specific statements which tells what is to be done and what is not to be done in a given situation. So they tells us what can be done by the managers and what cannot be done. This is called as rule. Rule is more strict than policy, and against the violation of rule, there are provision of fine and penalties. For example, smoking is not allowed inside the business premises. Or you can say mobile phone is not allowed in the school for the students. Or one more example can be, like a firm is having a rule that if a debtor is not paying money within 15 days, then 15% interest will be charged from that very debtor. So here 15% interest will be a penalty for that very debtor. That's why it will be the example of rule. So here, students, I think all the standing plans are clear to all of you. Now we will move to the single use plans. Single use plans are having two plans, that is program and budget. So firstly, see program. Program is the detailed statement of any project which outlines the objective, policy, procedure, rule, budget, as well as human and physical resources required to complete that very program. So program is including every type of plant. What I am saying here, program is a detailed statement of any project, and that detailed statement will outline what is the objective of that very project, what are the rules and policies will be followed in that project, what will be the budget of that project, and how much physical and human resources will be required in that very project. So everything will be explained by a program. For example, celebration of the annual day of company. So this will be the example of program. Or you can say Swachh Bharat Abhiyan started by our Prime Minister. That is also the example of program. Now students, move to the last plan, that is budget. Budget are the specific statement of expected result that are expressed in numerical terms for a definite period of time. For example, sales budget, production budget, cash budget, all these are the example of budget. Budget is a very important tool for planning as well as controlling. But budget involves forecasting about the future. That's why it is included under planning. So here our all plans are over. I think all are clear to all of you. If you have any doubt, you can discuss with me right now. Thank you, class.